Today on Sci Guys, solar oven s'mores.
Welcome to Sci Guys. I'm Ryan.
And I'm Teresa. And today we're making solar oven s'mores.
I can't wait to eat some s'mores, but there's something different about this kitchen and I can't put my finger on it.
Radiant heat is the transfer of heat energy through electromagnetic waves as opposed to through conduction or convection.
The equipment and ingredients you're going to need for this episode includes a deep cardboard pizza box,
aluminum foil,
plastic wrap,
tape,
a piece of dowel or ruler to hold open your oven,
scissors and a box cutter,
a ruler and a pen,
and stuff to make s'mores. The safety equipment for this experiment includes thermal gloves in case the inside of the oven gets very warm, as well as an apron or lab coat to protect from spills or splashes. Also, our younger viewers should use adult assistance when using the box cutter.
The first step in our experiment is to measure out the opening that we're going to cut in the roof of our box. Measure out with your pen and ruler an inch and a half from all four sides of your box. Then, connect all your measured out points together to make a square. With your box cutter, cut along the left and right edges of your box and the front edge, but leave the back edge uncut because this will be the flap that holds the reflective surface to our oven.
Next, we're going to line the interior of the box with aluminum foil. You want to make sure that the shiny side is facing into the box. Once you're finished, the inside should look like this.
Now we're going to cover the opening in our oven with saran wrap. You're going to want to stretch it tight and seal it with tape so that no air can escape. You may want to put a couple layers of saran wrap on to make sure that the heat is captured within the oven. Once you have your saran wrap on, your oven should look something like this. With your oven ready, we're ready to go outside.
Now that we're outside, you're going to take your s'more and put it into the solar oven. Then you're going to close the lid and prop open the top with dowels.
Depending on the temperature, it will take around an hour for the first s'more to melt. While the first s'more cooks, we built a second solar oven to test out if adding black paper to the inside of the solar oven would make a difference in the oven's air temperature. We then took the oven outside, placed a s'more into the oven, sealed it up, and left it in the sun. After about an hour outside, at a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius, we tested the temperature of the air within both ovens. The oven with only aluminum foil had an air temperature of 65 degrees Celsius. The oven with black paper reached a higher temperature of 75 degrees Celsius. In this side-by-side comparison, you can see that the oven with the black paper had a much easier time melting the chocolate. Once your s'more is melted, remove it from the oven, grab a second graham cracker, place it on top, and enjoy. Let's look at this experiment a little closer. All ovens require an energy source to cook or melt food. Some use electricity, and others use fuels like gas, but they all convert energy into heat. In the instance of our solar oven, the energy source is the sun. The sun produces high amounts of energy in the form of light. The light from the sun takes around 8 minutes to reach Earth. Once the light reaches Earth, it beams down onto our solar oven. The opening in the top of our oven lets light enter the oven, and the angled flap, which is coated with aluminum foil, helps to reflect additional light, which would normally miss the oven's opening, into the oven. When light enters the oven, it transfers energy to the air molecules by a method known as radiation, which converts light into thermal energy, raising the oven's air temperature. The thermal energy within our oven will quickly transfer to the environment unless a thermal insulator is used to trap the heat within the oven. Thermal insulation is the process of inhibiting the transfer of thermal energy from one area to another. A pizza box is a great thermal insulator. Pizza boxes are made to keep a piping hot pizza from getting cold by slowing the conduction of thermal energy to the environment. An insulated box keeps all the collected energy within the oven and allows the air temperature to rise much faster and higher than it could without thermal insulation. But why did the temperature in the oven with the black paper get higher than the one without? The color black is great at absorbing light, and a shiny surface, like aluminum foil, is great at reflecting light. When aluminum foil is at the base of our oven, it causes the light that enters the oven to bounce around and back out, which only captures some of the energy from the light. The black paper, on the other hand, absorbs most of the energy from the light that touches it, converting it to thermal energy, and that energy is transferred to the air molecules. The more energy from the light that is captured and absorbed, the higher the temperature our oven can get. As the temperature of the air in the oven rises, it transfers its thermal energy to the s'mores we placed inside, causing them to get soft and melt into a delicious snack.
That's it for Solar Oven S'mores. Thanks for watching.
If you enjoyed this episode, let us know in the comments below and subscribe for future episodes.
And remember to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.
And if you have any questions related to this episode or about science in general, let us know in the comments below or message us on Facebook and we'll try to help you as best possible. Thanks for watching. Bye!
Bye!
Those s'mores were delicious, but I still can't put my finger on what's changed in this kitchen. Here at SciGuys, we're always curious how experiments turn out. So if you do these experiments at home, share a video or photo of them with us on our Facebook or Google Plus page. But remember to always ask your parents' permission before you share any photos or videos.